Hey everyone, this is Ramey coming to you from the UMI Performance Race Shop in Phillipsburg, Pennsylvania. In this video, we're going to learn how to set the pinion angle on the third and fourth gen GM F-body. So the first step is to check the engine and transmission angle. You can do that with a digital angle finder. We sell an analog one on our website, and you can also use your smartphone. We're going to go to the harmonic balancer bolt, get it stabilized, and then press hold. I'm reading the angle at 2.45 degrees tail shaft down. As a bonus tip, we'll show why you can't use the oil pan. I'm reading 0.3 degrees, which is incorrect based on what we measured at the balancer. We're here at the back of the UMI Performance 99 Camaro. We have it sitting on cribbing blocks to get the rear axle in the proper position because we want to set pinion angle with the car loaded like it's ready to drive. The most common pinion angle recommendation is negative 2 degrees. A common misconception, however, is that this means 2 degrees nose down in relation to zero. What it actually means is 2 degrees down from the angle of the engine. So we had the front angle at 2.45 degrees tail shaft down. So if we were at zero here, we would be at 2.45 up this way. So the goal right now is to go down 2 degrees from that. So our goal is 0.45 degrees nose up. To set the pinion angle, we have a few procedures to do before we get to the actual setting. The first is to loosen the fasteners for the rod eye. We use a 15/16 for that, to loosen that. We have to loosen the fastener both on the top and the bottom to allow it to pivot properly. The next step is to use an inch and an eighth to break the jam nuts loose. This one is actually the opposite way, so we want to loosen it by tightening it. And then this one is right-hand thread, so we loosen that by loosening it. When we finally get around to setting the pinion angle, we use a 1-inch wrench on the middle adjuster. When we measured earlier, we were at 2.45 degrees tail shaft down on the UMI 99 Camaro. When we subtract our 2 degrees, that means we actually need 0.45 degrees nose up to give us our negative 2 difference. I'm gonna turn on my angle finder and I'll set that here. I can see that we're at 0.25 nose down. So we actually need to use our 1-inch wrench to go that up. That puts us at 0.45 nose up, 0.55. Now that we have our 2 degrees driveline difference from crankshaft centerline to pinion, we can talk about why we choose the 2 degrees. So when the car's sitting in the driveway ready to drive, it has that 2 degree difference. But when the drivetrain is loaded, like cruising down the highway or accelerating down the drag strip, things are gonna move and we want the crankshaft centerline and the pinion to end up parallel to each other. If we start at 2, that gives us a good head start to end up at 0 under load. That's why the 2 number doesn't need to be exactly 2. We can go, you know, 1.8, 2.1, something like that. If we have an all rubber car, meaning stock trailing arm stuff, we can do maybe 3 degrees. If we have an all rod end car where things aren't going to move so much, we can use as little as 1 degree of pinion angle. In closing, it's important to note that anytime you change the ride height, it's important to recheck the pinion angle. And also, if you have a slight vibration, you can turn the adjuster a quarter turn or half a turn one way or the other to try to get rid of that harmonic. If you have any further trouble, you can actually contact UMI Performance tech support at support@umiperformance.com and we'll do our best to help you.